Hey, Measuring Hero, Jay here. We spent a lot of time filming right here in the Customer Center in Oberkochen. We thought today we'll actually give you a proper tour of the facility. But who better to give us the tour than the proud papa to this whole room, Roland.
Hi, Jay.
Thank you for taking the time out of your day to show us your gorgeous room.
I will like it.
Perfect.
So, come on, let's go a little bit closer. So I will introduce you the three main areas here in this customer center. On one side, on this side, we have the training rooms. These are all offline rooms equipped with smart boards and computers. So there we can do trainings, also offline trainings, for example, for software or generally for measuring technology. So what you know maybe as the Occam trainings.
Sure,
so
sure.
we will do also here, as well as our trainings for our software and our special applications.
Mm-hmm.
In the background here, we have the demo center.
Mm-hmm.
So here we try to convince the customer that we have the right solution for his applications, for his requirements. And the last department what we have here, that's the software development. Now you can ask, why software development in a customer area? We want it like this because we want to have the software developers really close to application engineers. So they have directly contact to my people making the demo, also to the people they make the trainings. So there we get all the feedback from the customer, from the software, from the hardware, and we can bring in this inside software development.
That was a great idea to do that, absolutely.
Okay, so let's go further and look to the different technology we have.
Yeah.
We will not see every machine for sure not, but the main technology I will introduce to you and to the people outside here, and let's look.
Let's have a good.
So, one of the newest technology in the measuring area is the tomography. Okay, that's
CT, and you have a few of them.
We have a few of them. We have four of them here in this area. Yeah, I think that's also not
special.
So often the case. Yeah, that you have so much of these machines.
Yeah.
But with our new focus fields like battery in EV or other fields, we need this kind of technologies more and more and get more importance for the measuring area.
Okay,
we go from this fancy technology back to a classical CMM. So what we see here? A classical, we called it portal CMM, because we have such a portal called Contura. We will say that's a very nice mid-class machine, and in the meantime, it's our most sold machine. Okay, then let's go in the back here to a special application field.
Oh, okay.
So you see here, we called it the medical area. So here we have different kind of implants. What do you afterwards have in the body? Things like this. And things like this have to be measured. And we focus the last, I would say, since 2 years. To get inside this special field, medical field, and especially in the implants, we had a lot of things to measure. Also there we have the requirement to measure something tactile, but even also with a dot scan, with a confocal white light sensor, especially if you have very polished surfaces. You cannot do anything with the laser triangulation sensor. You have to use the dot scan, and there we have all the different solutions available.
Perfect.
So let's move to the O-Inspect. So the special thing of the O-Inspect is that we have three sensors parallel. So we have in the center, we have the camera, so we measure relay, we make pictures and measure inside the picture. So distances, circle diameters, and so on. Then we have Also here, our dot scan, our confocal wide light sensor, and here, the tactile sensor, and you can use all these different kind of probes here. Yeah.
Three for one.
And a very important thing is that's a fully integrated solution. So you have one reference point, you have one software, and you have one measuring record. Yeah? And customer like this, they appreciate this because they want not to deal with different software or different different measuring records.
There. I like this too.
That's right. Okay, Jay, let's go to another room, to a special machine. Yeah, very important machine for IQS. Let's move.
Okay.
So, you see here, we are in a special room. Mm-hmm. Yeah? You see here, we have temperature sensors here. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we really control the temperature. Sure. 24 hours, 7 days. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you have here a monitor where you can really look to your temperature. You can look what happens in the last 24 hours, 36 hours or whatever, mm-hmm. Last week. Yeah? Everything is recorded.
Yeah.
So let's go to the machine, the PRISMO. So the PRISMO is one of our most important machines for us, because also historical. Yeah, this machine is, you don't believe, more than 30 years old.
Really?
Yes, more than 30 years old. Okay, the first PRISMO looks different for sure.
Yeah.
Had other design, was not so accurate, not so fast and so on. So we improved this machine the last 30 years. Yeah. And in the end, we have I'm convinced one of the best machines you can get, measuring machines you can get on the market.
Sure. Yeah.
We have different kind of sensors also there. Mm-hmm. In the end, we have more than 25 sensors what we can really input in such a PRISMO. Yeah.
Wow.
And that's a lot of work to achieve this goal. Yeah, to be less than a micron. Yeah, and with all of this kind of machines.
Yeah.
We reach this goal, but you see, you need the right
environment. Special room. Yeah.
You need absolutely the right.
That doesn't happen by accident.
Absolutely.
How many of these rooms do you have here?
We have three rooms here
in this
area here, and they have special air condition. That's not right. We have even more because we have downstairs.
Oh, okay.
We have two more. Yeah, so there we have set up the PRISMO Ultra, and we have set up the XENOS. Yeah, the XENOS is our high-end machine.
Yeah,
if you compare it with, with the automotive industry, that will be the Formula One. Yeah, and the XENOS, the XENOS is really special, and because we are here in the sixth floor, so we set it up downstairs. Yeah, and there we have a specification of 0.3 microns divided by 1,000. So I think that's really unique on the market.
That's, let's call that unique.
Yeah,
for sure.
That's really unique on the market. Okay, so that's the PRISMO for us, very important machine. And let's move again to the next special area for NEV.
Great, yeah. I'm very excited about the, when I saw the NEV thing come up, because I'm looking for a new car, and I'm pretty sure it's going to be an electric car.
Yeah. So, as you mentioned, we had a big translation now from the classical engine to the electric engine. Yeah, and these are brand new requirements for us to measure this part. You see here, there are different parts what we use on an e-motor. Compare with a standard motor, it's a lot less components, but very, very, not too easy to measure, I will say. Yeah. You have new requirements, and one of the special parts is this part.
Hairpin.
Hairpin, yes. So we call this hairpin. These hairpins looking very, very easy, but to measure this, it's really high requirements there. So, and again, to the production area, we have also machine really specially designed for the production area. Let us go in this area. So what do we have here? It's a CenterMax. Yeah? If you look to this machine, it looks a little bit different to all the machine what we see before. It's also like a bridge, but you see totally other construction here. Yeah. And the idea is really to set up these machines direct in the shop floor area. I remember one of the first machines we set up at the customer site. It was so dirty there in this area. Yeah. The oil was running through the whole machine.
Gosh,
yeah.
Wow.
And this machine, and that's now, I will say, minimum 20 years, yeah, uh-huh. That machine still runs.
Still running. Oil running through it.
Oil running. Okay, the environment getting better, okay. Yeah, so no oil anymore, but at the beginning it was like this. Yeah. So these are really dedicated machines for shop floor, and normally they are integrated in the whole production process,
sure.
So you'll be automatic loaded normally with pellet systems or robots, yeah. And you get the results directly in your statistics software, and nobody will sit on the machine and do anything manual. That will be fully automatically.
Yeah. Made for shop floor. It's good. I rarely see these in the showrooms. So
absolutely, because
really
they are really normally will not set up in such an environment like here.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's really something for the shop floor. Yeah.
Perfect.
And on the other side, we have our DuraMax. Yeah? Mm-hmm. You look for the ending. Yeah, that's the CenterMax. That's the DuraMax. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So everything what ends with the word Max is for the shop floor.
Got it.
Also, remember the CT. Yeah, we have also a VolumeMax. Also there we have machines dedicated for a shop floor. Requirements.
Got it. Okay.
Yeah, and also there is very fast measurement. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And the DuraMax you can use in the shop floor area as well as in a measuring room. Yeah, I will say it's on the tactile side is our entry machine. Yeah, and what is very very nice and what also the production people like, that this machine have a very small footprint.
Sure.
Yeah?
Sure.
So and to learn all these things here, yeah, how to use the machine, how to work with the machines. Now we have additional training rooms here where you have also machine set up you can directly on the machine learn what you have to do and how you work with such a machine. Let's move to
Let's
the
have a
room.
Look, yeah.
So that's a typical room.
Sure.
Yeah.
I never get to film in here because it's always full.
It's normally always full, yeah, that's right. But you know, with the pandemic, we also set up a lot of online trainings. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And normally also the chairs are in another way here. So we have more space normally.
Sure.
Yeah. But here in the pandemic time where we have to look. Yeah. And you see, we have here two Prismos and two Acuras. Yeah? So we can directly, so the people can learn things and directly test it on the machines.
So, let me get this straight. You have sub-micron CMMs in your training room.
Absolutely.
So that your students can learn how to use these.
Yeah. And you see in the front, we have the, as also in the offline training rooms, we have the smart board. Yeah, so the trainer have good possibility to show things. He can also write things on the smart board, yeah. Copy this and give it to the students, yeah.
That's
so that's a really, really nice environment, yeah, for training. And I can always tell the people, come now to a training, because smaller classes, as in the moment, you will never get any more. Yeah.
Now's the way to do it, one-on-one, almost one-on-one.
Almost one-on-one, yeah.
Perfect.
And in the end, we have maximum, I think, four people now here for training, yeah. So everybody have his own machine, yeah. So it's perfect to learn the measuring technology in our machines. So we are on the end on this small tour. I can for sure I could tell you more hours, yeah. But I think it's a rough overview about what we do here in Oberkochen and. Hopefully it's interesting for you and also for the people outside.
It's thank always you. Interesting. Roland, thank you for a brief tour of your very, very special room here.
Yeah.
But we have one more, before we let you go, we have one more thing. We want to give a little quiz.
Okay.
You ready?
You ready?
Okay, let's do it. Welcome to the Measuring Hero Quiz. Okay, Roland, thanks for doing this. Appreciate it. I'll explain to you what's about to happen. I'm going to ask you two questions. The first question is about either a general metrology or something you might have learned watching these vlogs. The second question is something about something in Germany German culture or just something you might know living in Germany. And then we'll flip it and we'll let you ask me a question, any question of your choice.
Okay.
Sound good?
Sounds good.
Okay.
Let's do.
Here we go. First question. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. In 1919, we began our fine measurement department here at ZEISS.
Yes.
We presented our products at a trade fair in what German city?
Oh, I think it was Jena.
It was Leipzig. Leipzig.
Leipzig.
Leipzig.
So I'm wrong.
All right. I got you on that one. Okay. Second question. Which of the following three is a famous German musician and free jazz drummer?
Okay.
Is it A, Christoph Doom Schneider?
Okay.
B, Mani Neumer?
Neumer?
Yeah.
Okay.
Or C, Neil Peart?
What was the third name?
Neil Peart. He's a drummer from Rush.
No, then it was a... that's a good question. That was the first one, huh?
The first one? The first one, Christoph Doom Schneider is in fact a German drummer. He's the German drummer for Rammstein.
Ah, okay, so that's the wrong music.
Yes, a German drummer, but the free jazz drummer was, at least according to Wikipedia, was B, Mani Neumer. All right, but you know what, Roland? You get your chance to get revenge on me and ask me any question you want.
Yeah, when we are in history of ZEISS.
Okay.
Yeah. So we started, you know, more than 100 years ago.
Okay. Yeah.
And what was the once the founder and also the city where was ZEISS be founded?
Okay. Well, our founder is Carl ZEISS.
Absolutely.
Okay.
That was easy.
Okay. And the city, I guess, because I hear it all the time, I'm going to guess Jena.
Perfect.
Jena, yeah.
Right. You're right, Trey. Right. Perfect.
Okay, awesome. Roland, thank you for the tour of your facility and thank you for taking this quiz with us.
You're welcome.
Appreciate it. Hope you enjoyed it.
Yeah, for sure.
All right. And for you out there, I hope you enjoy this too. Don't forget to stay safe and stay healthy and see you next Thursday.